Hello, my name is Mel and this is Ben, and welcome to our video about our Mediterranean cruise on board P&O's Arvia. We hope you enjoy.
Today we were docked in Cadiz. What's fantastic about Cadiz is you dock right in the middle of the old town and everywhere is really walkable. As you disembark the ship, if you go straight across the road, you'll come across this monument, which celebrates the Constitution of 1812. As I mentioned, Cadiz is really quite small, so it's easy to walk around and you can't really get lost. It's well worth exploring the back streets and seeing what you can find. With a little help from Google Maps, we managed to find the cathedral. And just like that, we made it to the other side of the town. We came across this cute market, as well as this nice fountain. And of course, no port visit would be complete without the obligatory hop-on, hop-off bus. This tour costed €25 and did stop at a nice park halfway through, so I think next time I'd probably get off at that stop. Before long, it was time to say goodbye to our final port of call. And just like that, with only 2 sea days between us and Southampton, we are officially heading home. That evening, we dined in the main dining room and were lucky enough to be allocated a seat right by a window. I had the sweet and sour chicken with rice, whilst Ben had a chicken dish. For dessert, Ben had sticky toffee pudding, whilst I had a chocolate brownie with an orange sorbet. It was absolutely delicious. Another stunning sunset followed, so of course the obligatory filming had to happen. Tonight's entertainment was a set performed by Peter Howarth, the lead singer of the Hollies. Cause I'm going to be the same.
it's true. Never reaching the end. Lessons are written, never meaning sound. Beauty at always lives with these eyes before. Just what the truth is, can't say anymore. Cause I love you. Yes, I love you. Oh, I love
From our first of two sea days sailing back to Southampton. Tonight is celebration night, so we were left with these lovely towel swans on our bed. No free drinks voucher though. I started and finished this book today. I originally got it from the book swap in our village, and I'll be leaving it in the book swap on board. It seemed pretty apt for a cruise. I really enjoyed the book. It was fast-paced and kept me interested throughout. Highly recommended. The main dining room menus did not pique our interest tonight, so instead we decided to treat ourselves to another meal at the Keel and Cow. I forgot to take photos of our mains before we demolished them, but we both had the Prime Minister burgers again. Ben had the sticky toffee pudding for dessert, and I of course had the crumble. Both were absolutely yummy. We were lucky enough to be in the right place at the right time as we managed to witness one of the aerial acts in the atrium. It was funny as we were just talking over dinner to say that we hadn't seen one yet. I really liked the atrium on Arvia, I thought it was much better than the blue ceiling on Iona. It felt much more modern and classier.
I'm too sexy for my shirt, too sexy for my shirt, so sexy it hurts. And I'm too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Milan, New York and Japan.
Tonight's entertainment was a vocalist band called Triptonic. I believe they did two shows on this cruise, and I think one of them might have been on the night of Florence when I didn't feel very well.
And I try, and I try, and I try, and I can't get no.
Scenes tour, P&O put on a presentation in the theatre led by the third officer. It was really, really interesting to learn about what happens behind the scenes on Arvia. I do hope they bring back the ship tours in the future though, as I really enjoyed the one I did on Independence of the Seas. A quick pit stop for a sundae at the Ripples Ice Cream Bar, my new favourite place. And would you believe that was my last photo of that sea day? Here we are, back in Southampton. Most of our final day on board was spent packing, watching movies, reading our books, playing board games and just generally relaxing, while we still could. We opted to self-disembark, so we wanted to take our own suitcases off and get up to the train station. Ben went to the buffet, whilst I did a last sweep of the cabin to make sure that we had everything. I also stripped the beds to save time for our room attendant. We did have to wait a while before a lift came that was empty enough for us to get our luggage in. But we weren't in any hurry, as our train wasn't for another couple of hours. Bye-bye room! We left the ship on the same gangway on which we embarked 2 weeks ago, before walking through what I like to call the luggage pick and mix. Before saying goodbye to our home for the past 2 weeks. Bye-bye Arvia! I thought I'd end this vlog with a little cruising review Q&A. If you've made it this far, thank you very, very much for watching through our vlogs. We hope you enjoyed them. I look forward to making another one in just a few months' time when we visit Norway in September on the lovely Iona. Until next time, see you soon.